words from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 10, verses 38-42, from the Contemporary English Version of the Bible. The Lord and his disciples were traveling along and came to a village. When they got there, a woman named Martha welcomed him into her home. She had a sister named Mary who sat down in front of the Lord and was listening to what he said. Martha was worried about all that had to be done. Finally, she went to Jesus and said, "Lord, doesn't it bother you that my sister has left me to do all the work by myself? Tell her to come and help me." The Lord answered, "Martha, Martha, you are worried and upset about so many things, but only one thing is necessary. Mary has chosen what is best, and it will not be taken away from her." Here ends the reading. Thanks be to God. Martha was busy, and Martha was anxious. She was stuck in the kitchen by herself, doing all the work, preparing all the food, getting everything ready for everyone. Sound familiar? We know what this is like. We've been there before. We've been the ones trying to get everything ready, feeling like no one is helping, feeling like no one even notices how hard we're working. It's not fun. And right now, we've especially been preparing ourselves to stay safe and healthy. And it's exhausting and it's anxiety producing. And then there's Mary. Mary chooses to stay still. Mary chooses to sit at the feet of Jesus. And Jesus says to everyone there, "Martha, you are worried and upset about so many things, but only one thing is necessary. Mary has chosen what is best, and it will not be taken away from her." Now the lesson here is not that it is bad to work or to prepare or to even be prepared, but that we also need times of connection to God, deep connection to God. It means making space to tune into the holy, loving peace that is available to us. It means making space in our lives to stop and to go right up and sit at the feet of Jesus ourselves, just to receive some loving care, some peace and quiet, some comfort and support. When was the last time we stopped just to get still? Because here's the thing, what Mary chose could not be taken away from her, because no one can take Jesus and his love away from us. No one. And no virus, and no panic, or social distancing, or canceling of events, none of those things can take away the love and peace and hope and joy we have within us that we were born with, that is of God. None of that can be taken out of us or away from us. And in order to get out of that anxious kitchen and over to the feet of Jesus, only one thing is necessary. That one thing is to tune in to God, to get nearer to God. It seems so easy. Yet we find ourselves standing in that kitchen all the time, letting our anxiety and our fear get the best of us. I mean, look at how most of us start our days. We wake up, we check our phones, we check our schedules, and we check the news, and the stock market, and we check our emails. And all of these things need to be checked, especially right now. But what if we did one important check-in first? What if we took a moment to make some space within, to tune in to God, to start our day at the foot of Jesus, listening to what he has to say to us, listening and tuning in, very different from tuning into the news or to our cell phones. Thing is, God doesn't always use words. So what's the point of tuning in and listening to God if God is not speaking words to us? Well, the point is to get out of the worry and into the holy. To get out of the anxious kitchen for a while and get ourselves sitting at the feet of Jesus. The point is to start in holiness and peace instead of bombarding our souls with all we have to do, with all that's going on out there. What if we started in God? And what if we stayed in God? And what if we ended in God? What would the next 2 weeks look like if we did that? Well, we probably find that we are not just tuning into God, but that we are fine-tuning our ability to really sit at Jesus' feet and get still enough to just listen. To listen to his guidance for our lives. To tune into his love that is so available to us. To tune into his comfort and his soothing care. When we are in tune to God like that, we enter the world differently. And we approach our relationships differently. And we manage our stress differently. And when we do all of this, it is so that when we find ourselves feeling all alone in the kitchen, doing all this work to stay safe and healthy, our souls can be tuning into a different task, one of being present to the Lord. And that way, we can find ourselves sitting at the feet of Christ, no matter where we are actually sitting. But it takes practice. Practice we have to make space for in our lives. Space we can make first thing in the morning to set the tone for our day. And that might mean setting our alarms 10 minutes earlier for tuning in to God's presence of us, for us. But where else can we make some space to tune into God in our lives, especially during these times? What other times during our day can we make space to tune into God that feels good and right and natural to us, that feels most needed? Because we could be strategic about this. If we have a difficult moment coming up, we can plan to just sit wherever we are, just like Mary, at the feet of Jesus, and tune in to the love of God that comforts and cares, that settles our souls and gets us ready to go so we can do what we have to do with God right alongside of us, right with us. For we are not alone. We have a constant holy companion that gives us an eternal strength beyond what we ever thought we could do ourselves. And Bailey Parnell, founder and CEO of Skills Camp, went to visit an orange grove one time where an irrigation pump had broken down. The season was unusually dry that year, and some of the trees were beginning to wither for lack of water. The man giving the tour took Bailey to his own orchard, where irrigation was used sparingly. "These trees," he said, "could go without rain for another 2 weeks. You see, when they were young, I strategically kept them from water, and this caused them to send their roots deeper into the soil in search of moisture. And now," he says, "my trees are the deepest rooted trees in the area, and they are finding moisture at a greater depth instead of being scorched by the sun." When we were young, being rooted and created in love, God was in the kitchen, working, preparing, strategically planning for us so we could forever find our stillness. so we could find peace at a greater depth instead of being scorched by anxious times. One thing is necessary during these times. May we tune into it, because God has not been taken from us.